Teardrops.
I wish I had one of these, you know, just mine. This is Ian's bus. See, this is the thing about AR. It's not just about sending out the free or free gear, I should say. It's all about getting involved and helping out from start to finito. So what we're doing today is we are, Matt wants all chrome hardware on his drums. So I had to order all the parts in, they air shipped him from Japan. And now we're going to switch out every single nut and bolt on his drum kit.
Let's move all this way.
This is our little land now.
Keep out.
We own this area. This is where we open the box and there's like...
That's all wrong.
Odds. Yeah, you've got all the part numbers wrong.
Because the thing is, the problem is, if I've ordered one wrong part, we can't do any of it.
Did you get that?
It's true though.
So, just to confirm, if he's ordered one wrong part, we can't do anything today.
So basically, blame Ian. Any endorsers out there, yeah. You order the wrong part, blame Ian.
All right, here we go. Is this all you ordered? Bubble wrap. Yeah. Oh, wait, let's see the colour. You ready? Please be chrome. Yes.
Happy day.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll tell you what.
Stage
tell
one.
This has come from TAMA. Actually, good quality packaging. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. So this is something that every tech should have. Look at this. Andy brings his own lovely cushion. It's like walking on air. Oh look, Andy, your concern was this.
Yes!
Fingerprints? Bloody hell.
So, fingerprints? Mate, there's going to be a lot of fingerprints on it by the end of today.
Put them on, you dirty. Go on.
Oh, thank you. Okay, look. This is the gloves that I get.
Yeah, just...
Look, and he gets the... Look at that.
Because I'm not a white... Because right. I can't wear them, because I'm not a white glover. Right, so.
They're going. Oh, yes! Yes! Now, to anyone else, it would so not be exciting to find tension rods, but when you're not entirely certain that you've ordered them or not...
I knew I ordered them. We definitely should give a big shout-out to Tama as well, because...
Yeah, without the boys in the Mitch in Japan, Sam in America.
Yeah, thank you guys.
I don't seem to see any
16s or 18s.
No, these are 16s.
18?
Haven't come across them yet.
Oh yeah. Come on.
Yeah, boy.
Why did you do that? There's two more boxes left in the box.
I'm just
what a bed.
I just love to wind him up, he's so good. You see his face just drop.
It does, yeah. Look at that though.
Do you know what?
It's the little things.
You said it, mate.
Oh, is there cookies on?
Oh God, these are the best thing you'll ever eat.
Better than a cookie.
Oh my God, I love a street waffle, yeah.
There's no.
There you are.
Oh my God. Oh, it is exactly the caramel sugar injected fuel you need for a day like this.
I think it's going to look so nice.
I think it's going to look amazing.
I think like Black Nickel had its time. This is the stuff you need to keep.
I'm going
to
say.
I love having a pepper decal day with
nice,
you.
Isn't it?
Lovely.
It's really nice. Having a bloody wonderful day.
Oh my God. Does it get any sexier?
Right, if we could actually, you know, we could actually get this done.
Yeah, we'll boss this out, mate.
Before, so we can actually have the A-rig.
Can you imagine if he walked in and it was all done?
It will be
done. Look on little Matthew's face.
It'll be done, we'll get it done. Oh, we can work that out, can't we?
Look at that. Should we get drum one out then?
Let's get it out, yeah.
Look at that. Spectacular. Look at that finish. Pink champagne sparkle. And now we're about to take all the lovely brushed nickel off of it. Off we go. silk.
Yeah, you've done a good job looking after these, big man.
Oh, Ian. Oh, for sake. Half a job.
Can you imagine if I accidentally dropped this? Oh my.
Just get you to give us another one.
I'm trying to explain it's not all about just sending out free gear.
I mean, if you drop it, you're the best person to be dropping it.
And you've got, obviously,
your bibinga
inside. How nice is that?
It's a little wood grommet to do it for me.
Yeah.
The reason why I'm helping Andy do this today, is because he's got 3 hours to get this completely done from start to finish, and it's just not realistic, one man. So, I want to support my man.
Oh, is he?
I mean, don't leave that in. You're gonna have to bleep out all the swearing.
Yeah. It's gonna be right carnage, isn't it? Like,
yeah, good luck with that. Yeah. It'll be like
the one word.
Andy, you... beep. It'll be beep and beep.
Basically, the one word that you shouldn't say.
Look, he quickly went to that. There, good man. He saw that coming a mile off. That's it. See, look. That's how the pros do it. I've already done mine.
Off. You haven't got floor tom brackets. Yeah, it is, mate. It's a bigger drum and he's got floor tom brackets.
Either that or someone just likes a chat.
Someone just likes. Which drum's going to fall apart?
Oh, don't say that, mate, because if the rack
fall
off.
Which drums are going to, on the first show, main stage Reading, headline slot, what's the first?
Look, you wait, because if that happens, I'm going to be stood up there watching.
And
gonna
I'm
going
to hear it. I know, I'm going to go, that was Ian, mate.
That's Bushy, mate.
It was. Who put that one together? Ian did.
Bushy.
So, I'll have no problem shucking you under the bus.
Yeah, I bet. Here we go. Here's a little anecdote for you. Matt got in touch with me about coming over to TAMA. And I was like, yes, Matt Nicholls, bring me Horizon. Definitely my biggest signing today. This is so sick. So we came up for the day. We spent a day hanging out and getting to know each other and specking out a kit. I ordered it, and bear in mind, when you get a custom build, it's like 4 months until it gets here. It's a long time. So 4 months went by. I knew when his kit was landing. Got on the phone to him, Matt, come up. Yeah, we'll go for lunch. We'll get your kit out. We'll do an unboxing video. It'd be great. So he came up to headstock. I got a box out, and he took it out. He said, it's the wrong colour. I was like, what? He said, yeah, it's the wrong colour. So, oh my God. And we had ordered 2 drum kits of this particular spec. So we had 2 kits in his full spec that he needed like within 6 weeks of that date, because he was doing a load of shows. And they were both the wrong colour. What am I doing now?
Matt's exact words were, just not quite pink enough.
So fortunately, because TAMA are legends, especially Mitch Odenarka, shout out Mitch, I got straight in touch with him and they turned 2 rigs round, 2 brand new rigs within 6 weeks. So then it landed and I got Matt back up and he said, Bushy, it better be a right colour this time. And it was, so marvellous. But then we did make up for it because Matt is actually the only person in the world, I think, with a Speed Cobra remote hi-hat pedal. They only do it in the Iron Cobra, like the black pedal, but he specifically wanted the Speed Cobra with a long footboard, so they made it.
I said to him, I was like, we had the Speed Cobra, like double pedals, and then Speed Cobra hi-hat stand, and I was like, it's just going to be so weird. Like, I like everything to be matching. And I reached out to you and then you said they've never done one, but...
They've not done one since.
It looked mega.
Like, yeah,
it was awesome. This drum kit has been like flooded twice. We did Lollapalooza in back here.
Flooded?
Yeah, like this whole kit is like... If you look now, if you look in the tension rods, that's the only bit of damage that you'll see is like a tiny bit of rust in there, because the day after I stripped everyone apart and WD-40 every single piece that I could get to, like whilst on tour, so you have to be a bit thrifty with time. But yeah, the whole kit was like absolutely, like, took the bass drum part and like inside the between the head and the hoop, which is like stacked of water.
And then again, that's a testament to the quality of the drums, man, because you know, as soon as water hits wood, you know, unless it's like treated, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But they've done so well and they sound amazing.
This is unbelievable. Can't get one.
Which one?
So it just pops
this
up.
One?
All of them.
Down again.
Oh yeah, there is a technique there, is there? So you'll be trying to be really careful and pull them out gently, whereas he's just bending them to the side, look.
Oh, you've been pulling them?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, no, you just snap it.
Here, Andy. Every day's a learning day. Do you know what I love about TAMA as well, right? If you look at where the seam is on that drum, it blends in so well. So it's underneath the drum, so you never see it. But it's just, they just do it so well. Yeah, look, where is it, look. So on here, where's the seam?
Seam? Who knows, because you wouldn't know.
Exactly.
Let's say.
Look how spectacular that is. They do it so well, you can barely see it. They're just bloody great drum builders. Right way round!
How is that the right way round? Oh, we missed it!
On the way around. Oh, damn you and your ways. That's the right way around now, because I've done this really clever thing.
Well,
I've looked at the word and decided it needs to be upright.
So what you've done is you've been working for TAMA for a long time when the brackets used to be mounted the correct way around. Not the correct way around, but the way around before they had the new
quick lock tom bracket. So, this is, I would say this is, without a shadow of a doubt, the best invention in the drum market today, and I'll tell you for why. What we have is, that goes on your floor tom leg, so you put it in there, lock it off, so that's your memory lock, as well as where your floor tom is supposed to be. I mean, these guys.
Just saves loads of time, it's great. It's very handy. I love TAMA because they constantly like reinvent things, and like you say that, like, oh, you can't reinvent it, they definitely try. It's awesome. If you look through their catalogue, like little things like they do like a hoop clamp for a microphone, or they do like a just mad stuff that is, you can tinker around. If you're a tinkerer, you'll love it. I love it. Sorry.
Yeah, how long do you say you've had this kit?
So you've had this kit for 4 or 5 years.
And how many shows would you say it's done?
Hundreds.
Really?
Yeah, hundreds, yeah. This has been in and out of them cages hundreds of times, yeah.
That's mad. The condition of it is so good. I mean, it is testament to you and how you look after the drums, but
treat it like it's your own. It's not like a rental. It's Matt's kit, but it's, you know, it's my baby as well. And yeah, I think you look at the craftsmanship that goes into it, and like look at the edges, like everything about it is perfect.
They do take pride in their bearing.
And if someone takes pride in what they do, you should take pride in what you do. Like when people trash kits and stuff, like. It's fine if that's what they want to do, but like I always feel for like the people who have built it. Do you know what I mean? Because you know, people who smash up guitars and stuff, that's been like handcrafted in a factory. Someone's put like a lot of time. And I know like that's their job. They build guitars or drums or whatever. But you know, I just think if you can look after something that someone's.
Do you know what? That is one thing that. So the attention to detail that goes into these drums is unbelievable. The master craftsmanship, even down to like. You know, the spraying and the way that you've got on the Iron Cobra production line, there's these people that all they do literally all day is pick up a screw a little bit like that, grease it, and then screw it. I mean,
yeah, that's good.
Like, do you know what I mean? Just
like when I used to work in a drum shop called Sound Attack, and
shout out Sound Attack.
Yeah, shout out Sound Attack because they are legends. Pete and Scott. When you unbox the kit, like. The packaging when you order a new kit is second to none. There's not really any damaged shells or that, like, all the tension rods are like perfectly laid out. Everything's like perfectly wedged down. Like you know it's a TAMA kit when you open it because it's just.
Well, I think they
just solid.
They pour their heart and soul into it, like you do with what you do.
Yeah.
They're exactly the same.
Yeah. Yeah, go on. Yeah, go for it. It's cool.
Who's over here? Hey! Scott! Hello!
Here's my camera.
How you doing, bud? Alright?
Good, man. I'm good. Check this out.
Yeah, boy.
That's cool.
That looks amazing, man. That looks fantastic, Scott. Funny enough, we're just building the rig
really
now.
Good, that's a really good time. That looks amazing, man. Oh, that's so good.
These are the guys that they're like our go-to people to do kick drum decals or printed bass drum heads, rezo heads. So he did Matt's last one. He's just done Matt's new one, and it looks wicked. And this, okay. So that's going to go out for this show at Reading this weekend, which by the time you see this video would have happened. So good.
Mate, that's unreal.
See, it looks when the sunlight got behind it then.
Well, it's done it as a decal. The TAMA was a decal.
Oh, is it?
So they stuck that on, but like it even looks like it's been like, you know, when they do that printing pen.
Yeah, it does. It is a bit of a geek out putting heads on moment. What's your method, Andy?
Finger tight and then opposite.
What? Opposite?
Finger tight.
Opposite and to the left or right and opposite and left to the right and opposite? Or do you just go
all finger tight, doesn't really matter, all the way around. So just just go around like that, spin it. And then I go opposites, 12-6. And then I will go 9-3. So like you're pulling the tension down on like the extreme that side, then extreme that side, and then extreme that side, then extreme that side.
Well, so I'm doing from there, opposite. Finger tight, and then to the left, or my right, and opposite. Everyone has their own way of tuning, you know. Some are more old school than others. Andy's clearly a bit old school. People who don't know, they go to a Bring Me show, a show of any type. They see the drums on stage, they just, you know, it's just like, it just happens. Do you know what I mean? It's just like there's nothing that goes on behind the scenes. There's a drum kit, it's been set up, let's play a show. But it's so much more in depth than that. There's so much to do. It's unbelievable. And Andy is just good at doing it.
Cool. Shall we?
Yep.
Where are we wheeling to?
Going to the lift.
Which is.
Yeah. What do you do one at a time anyway?
Well, just try it.
Loads of steps. I'm really heavy.
Yeah, so Matt just like, I mean, he knows exactly what he wants. All any sort of, you know,
Tom, are you all battery up?
Drummer just wants consistency, like, what, you know. Yeah, like he wants to sit down at the kit right and it feel like the kit that's been in the studio for 50 years, it's never moved. Do you know what I mean? Like, you want it to, it travels every day, it's a different stage every day, you know, and you just want to sit down and be like, feel like you're at home. Do you know what I mean? He should sit down and just be like comfortable straight away. If he's not comfortable, it can then, you know, he shouldn't have to think about stuff like that. He shouldn't be like, oh, I need to move that, I need to move that. It should be like, I can focus on what I'm doing. You know, and it's down to like the millimeter. It's like, you know, yeah. It should be. Do you know what I mean? Like, you shouldn't have to. No drummer should have to sit down and have to move stuff.
Like. Especially at this level of player.
Yeah.
I hope this has been a nice little insight into the day and the life of a drum tech and what it is for the drum tech AR relationship and all that sort of thing. Yeah, it's been good fun.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. Yeah, thank you.
It's been hard work doing that, eh? I say it's been hard work.
It's quite a normal day for me, to be honest. But yeah, thanks for everyone sort of at TAMA for all your help over the years as well. So, you know, Ian and everyone in Japan, America.
It's what
guys
we
are
do,
awesome.
Man.
So
what
yeah,
we do.
Big thanks to you guys for like dropping everything last minute and helping us out. So really appreciate
pleasure.
It. Yeah, yeah. So now on to the big rock show.
The show. Yeah. And then that's where we drop him with a boom.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, cool.
Sounds
see
good.
You later.
Thank you.